Hi guys, welcome back to an academy. So this is the daily analysis of the Hindu for today, that is the 31st of January 2017. So January has also ended now very quickly. This month passed away, so only few months left for prelims, so time to shift gears now guys. So this will be presented to you by me, Dipanshu Singh. You can read more about me on this slide and you can also follow me on academy on this link. And please rate and review the course. So last video for this month, so we'll start a new course tomorrow. So please rate and review the course and therefore recommend each and every video. Now the practice question for today is, which campaign has been organized by the Union Government on 2017's Anti-Leprosy Day for the National Leprosy Awareness? So these are your options. And the answer for yesterday's question is, Vijay Bhatkar has been appointed as the new Chancellor of the Nalanda University, and who is also considered the father of Indian supercomputer. Now, the first page news is regarding BCCI's reform under the Lodha panel's recommendation. So the Supreme Court has appointed a four-member committee, which will be headed by Vinod Rai, which will oversee the Board of Control for Cricket in India. So as you know, Vinod Rai has been the former Comptroller, Auditor General of India, and he's also heading the Bank Board Bureau. Apart from that, the other three members are the former women test cricketer Diana Edulji and historian Ramchand Guha, and the IDFC Limited MD and CEO Vikram Limaye. So they will function as the interim bosses of the BCCI and run the day-to-day administration of the cricket body till the Lodha reforms are fully implemented and elections are held. So the court also had asked the BCCI CEO to submit a report to the committee, and the BCCI CEO has to submit the report to the new committee within a week. And after this, the committee has been given 4 weeks to scrutinize the compliance achieved, and the report will be submitted back to the Supreme Court. Now, if you look at some of the key recommendations of the Lodha committee, so this is just a kind of revision. So it recommended one state, one vote. The biggest contentious issue was the age limit of 70 years for administrators, and a 9-member apex council instead of working committees, 9-year tenure for administrators, and cooling period for after every 3-year term, and a 3-member selection committee to pick the Indian team. Now, the central government will hold a tripartite talks with the United Naga Council and the Manipur government to end the ongoing Manipur blockade, which has been going on from several months, and which has actually disrupted the normal life and led to a shortage of essential commodities in the state. So if you look at the map of the Manipur state, the main region of conflict where the protest broke out were in this area of Churanchandpur. And the background, if you look at of the economic blockade, it was actually imposed by the United Naga Council, which is an umbrella body of the Naga groups under the patronage of National Socialist Council of Nagaland. And they were actually against the Manipur government's decision to carve out 7 new districts. So these are some of the issues which they were protesting against. So the blockade has basically continued for 4 months now, and the United Naga Council has said that the villages have been appropriated and merged. Villages have been merged with non-Naga areas to form the new districts in an attempt to divide the Naga people. And the other issue is that the government also did not consult the hill area committees before taking the decisions. And if you look at the hill area committees, are set up and formed to protect the rights of hill people under the provisions of the Constitution of India under Article 371C. So this is important. It can be asked in UPSC prelims about the hill area committee, whether it is mentioned in the Constitution of India. So generally recommendations and consultations are should be taken from the hill area committees on matters relating to tribal people, which was not taken as per the claims of the United Naga Council. And therefore this UNC sees creation of this new district as an attempt to truncate the concept of the greater Nagalim. And according to the government, the decision for formation of these 7 new districts was only administrative convenience and to enable the state government to take up developmental works effectively in the northeastern state. And the Hill Valley Divide has actually grown and has deepened over the past 2 years, as the demand for introducing the inner line permit issue in Manipur made the Métis community has gathered momentum. So this was also in news due to the inner line permit issue in Manipur for this community. The next one is science related news. So is boron can be and can and may become the next nanomaterial of the century. So the two atoms, wide ribbons and single atom chains of the element possess unique properties. So if metallic ribbons of borons are stretched, they morph into antiferromagnetic semiconducting chains, which can be used as a nanomaterial for conductivity, and when released they fold back into ribbons. So there are also efforts, labs are making progress into synthesizing atom thin and fullerene type boron which makes us think that 1D boron may eventually become real very soon. And carbon atom chains are known as carbine, and boron fullerenes and two-dimensional films called borophene, all predicted by the RAS groups, have since been created by the labs. Now they're predicting one-dimensional boron chains. Now, this news has been taken in, from the Live Mint newspaper. This was not in the Hindu, but then it was important. So, space travel may cause changes in the gene expression and other biological markers in astronauts. This is as per a study by NASA. So, scientists have studied the genetic differences between astronaut Scott Kelly's, who has spent nearly space, and his identical twin Mark. So, the measurements found that before and during after Scott Kelly's mission, there were changes in his gene expression, DNA methylation, and other biological markers that are likely to attribute to his time during the orbit spent in space. Now, scientists have created a new artificial skin that can actually feel temperature changes, which could possibly be used as prosthetic limbs to act as a sensitive artificial skin. So this is known as pectin, and this material uses a mechanism that is very similar to the pit organ in vipers. And pectin is basically very cheap and is widely used in the food industry as a jellifying agent. So these all three are very important news for prelims from science and tech point of view. And environmental related news, so Bombay Natural History Society has launched a climate change program in Central Himalayas. So the Bombay Natural History Society, which is headquartered in Mumbai, has launched this program to study and assess the status, distribution and conservation of pheasants and finches. These are the birds in Central Himalayas. So do read about these birds, pheasants and finches. And it is a long-term monitoring project funded by Oracle and facilitated by CEF India. It will also focus on their conservation in the context of climate change with the help of community participation. And if you look at about this organization, Bombay Natural History Society is one of the largest non-governmental organizations in India, which is engaged in conservation and biodiversity research, which was founded on 15 September 1883 and headquartered at Hornbill House in Mumbai. And it supports many research efforts through grants and publishes the Journal of Bombay Natural History Society. Now, important space phenomena has been observed and captured by our space observatory, that is AstroSat. So it has captured the rare phenomena of a small 6 billion year old vampire star preying on a bigger celestial body. So vampire stars, which are also known as blue straggler, basically suck out the energy of a bigger nearby star. So these vampire star phenomena is observed when smaller star, this sucks out the material, which is the mass and energy, out of the bigger companion stars, causing its eventual death. So this is the smaller star, or also known as the blue straggler, sucking out the energy and mass from the bigger star. And if you look at AstroSat, it is India's first dedicated multi-wavelength space observatory, launched in September 2016, which is placed at low Earth equatorial orbit and an altitude of 650 kilometers, and it has ability to observe celestial bodies at different wavelengths at the same time. Now, very important news from the point of ancient history and art and culture. So how Indus Valley civilization coped with climate change, because there have been numerous studies and reports which said that Indus Valley civilization declined due to climate change, and there was sort of shifting of the Indus course, and obviously there are theories of Aryans invading the civilization. But this is a report and a study which has confirmed that Indus Valley civilization underwent a period of climate change about 4,000 years ago. Who suggests that the ancient population in India used a variety of subsistence practices to cope with diverse environments. So water was one of the most crucial thing for them, and obviously it is very crucial for every civilization. So for most ancient complex society, water was a critical factor, and the availability of it and the way it was managed and used provide a critical insight into human adaptation and resilience of subsistence properties and practices. And most early complex societies developed in regions where there were the climatic parameters faced by ancient subsistence farmers were varied and not especially diverse. So Indus Valley civilization was situated very close to a deep lake called Kotla Dahar, which would have been primarily monsoonal, and there have been evidence of a dramatic decrease in water level in monsoon rainfall, and also a progressive lowering of the lake level. And second of these, lake also shows that it became ephemeral during 2200-2000 BC as a result of an abrupt weakening of the monsoon. So basically, there were effect of climates and which caused the eventual de-urbanization. So the proximity of the Kotla Dahar record to the area which was occupied by this population must be formally considered as a contributing parameter in the process of Indus de-urbanization, at least in the context of the plains of northwestern India. So it has been observed that the people adapted various techniques. Cultivating, and there was evidence of use of military ice and tropical tropical pulses in the pre-urban and post-urban phases of the Indian civilization that confirms that they diversified their subsistence practices. And this also suggests that the local Indus population were already well adapted to living in varied and variable environmental conditions even before the development of the urban centers. Now, the business page news. So banks, Gyan Sangam will discuss digitization and consolidation of the public sector banks. So Gyan Sangam, which is kind of a banker's retreat, decided to discuss on various issues ranging from digitization, consultations of PSBs in its March gathering. So the push for digitization in the wake of demonetization and the proposal for the public sector bank consolidation are likely to top the agenda. The idea of basically organizing is to provide them an informal academic environment which can bring about creative ideas and the best minds together of professionals and regulators. Apart from that, an important issue which will be discussed is on the likely proposal of setting up of the National Asset Management Company or a BAD Bank, which is a special category asset reconstruction company with stakeholders including government and the private sector for takeover and turnaround of bad loans, stressed assets and restructured assets. Now, audits will check the stent prices. So the coronary stent prices, which were included in the national list of essential medicines after a petition was filed before the Delhi High Court and is regulated by the National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority. Its pricing will be checked by the independent auditors. This is as per a report of hospitals taking a huge cut after the activists have demanded that the government should develop standard treatment guidelines for cardiovascular interventions with the help of expert doctors free from conflict of interest and implementing medical audits of procedures. So we had covered the similar news on the amount of profit these hospitals make on the price of a stent. So if the NPPA data shows that the price of the stent increased nearly 2,000% by the time the patient gets the implant. So there has been a rampant misuse of the pricing and misuse of this limitations of the government in checking its prices, and therefore they're abusing the hospitals are abusing their availability and affordability of these stents to charge higher for the customers. So if you look at the coronary stents, how does it work? So basically it's like a balloon type of device which is inserted in the coronary artery which carries blood to the heart. So they generally gets shrunk due to plaque or the cholesterol which is accumulated in these arteries. So once it is entered, it is the balloon is used to increase the blood flow and expand this narrowed artery, which ultimately widens the artery and relaxes the patient and prevents the patient from a possible heart attack. So this is it for this video, guys. Till next video, I hope you have a good day. Thank you so much.